people visit Sable Island, there's a chance to reconnect with nature. It's a place that's so remote and so wild, and it's so difficult to reach that once you do get there, that solitude, that sound of just the ocean, sound of just the wind whistling through the marum grass, it makes you realize that there are places that are untouched in the world. And it's very special to spend a day like that on Sable Island. The special connection I have with Sable Island is that I literally wouldn't be here without this place. My great-grandparents met on Sable Island during World War I. My great-great-grandfather was the superintendent at that time. 7 kids he brought out, and his daughter, Muriel. And Muriel met a young lifesaver named William. William Mott. He was born in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, and as a young man kind of seeking adventure, he applied to be a lifesaver out on Sable Island. And so these two kids ended up falling in love and moving off island and getting married. Since 2017, we've been offering tours of the Sable Island. For myself, it's an absolute privilege to be able to showcase not only the beauty of this wild and magical place, but also share my family's history and connection to this ribbon of sand off the coast of Nova Scotia.